So we're outside Bergdorf Goodman, where they've got a display of Dolce & Gabbana shoes. And it's kind of amusing to me because about 30 years ago, I wrote an article called Famine, Affluence, and Morality, in which I imagined that you're walking past a shallow pond, and as you walk past it, you notice that there's a small child who's fallen into the pond and seems to be in danger of drowning. And you look around to see where the parents are, and there's nobody in sight. You realize that unless you wade into this pond and pull the child out, the child is likely to drown. There's no danger to you because you know the pond is just a shallow one, but you are wearing a nice pair of shoes and they're probably going to get ruined if you wade into that shallow pond. So, of course, when I ask people this, you know, they always say, well, of course, forget about the shoes. You've just got to save the child. That's clear. And then I stop and say, okay, well, I agree with you about that. But for the price of a pair of shoes, if you were to give that to Oxfam or UNICEF or one of those organizations, they could probably save the life of a child, maybe more than one child, in a poor country where children are dying because they can't get basic medical care to treat very basic diseases like diarrhea or whatever else it might be. And that's really one of the reasons why I think it's interesting to be here on Fifth Avenue talking about ethics. Because ethics is about the basic choices that we ought to make in our lives. And one of those choices is, how do we spend our money?